here's the water cycle model, which you were likely taught years ago while in school. As you can see, it explains that water in the oceans evaporates, forms clouds, and then goes back to Earth as rain, ice, or snow. And eventually through rivers and streams, the water goes back into the ocean. This conceptual model is a highly simplified explanation, but for most purposes, it's efficient. People form conceptual models all the time, and it's the responsibility of the designer to help the person form a useful conceptual model. It doesn't have to be complete, it can be an approximation, but it has to be usable. In the absence of clues from the designer, the person is very likely to develop an inaccurate model, which means they will eventually be confused. For your next exercise, find a reasonably complex activity that you frequently do and explain your conceptual model for it. You may use a combination of text or drawings, organization of your kitchen, how you store things in your room, or the operation of the equipment in your entertainment center are all good examples of everyday situations that can be amazingly difficult to explain to others. You can use one of these examples or choose one of your own.